This is going to be a video on reflex assessment of the lower extremity. Hi and welcome back to Physiotutors. Reflex assessment is an essential part of neurological examination when suspecting radiculopathy, as abnormal deep tendon reflexes may help you in identifying the pathological disc level. Al-Nazari et al. From 2013 performed a systematic review and meta-analysis of 14 different studies investigating sensory, motor, and reflex testing for lumbar disc herniations. The results showed that reflex testing had a sensitivity ranging from 25 to 29% and a specificity ranging from 75 to 78% in the identification of the pathological disc level. Pooled positive likelihood ratios for all neurological examination components ranged between 1.02 and 1.26, so positive or negative findings don't raise the post-test probability much at all, which is why we attribute this assessment a rather weak clinical value. Despite these findings, it is still the best tool we have in physical assessment. The most important lower extremity reflexes we're going to look at are the patella tendon reflex for L3-L4 segments, and the achilles tendon reflex for L5-S1 segment. You can grade the reflex according to a commonly used 5-grade scale. 0 equals no response, which is always abnormal. 1 plus equals slight but definitely present response, which may or may not be normal. 2 plus equals brisk response, which is usually considered normal. 3 plus equals a very brisk response, which may or may not be normal. 4 plus equals a clonus, which is always abnormal. If you want to learn about a pathological lower limb reflex, check out our video on the Babinski sign on the left. Click the link in the top right corner or check the first link in the video description if you want to learn about ways how you can support what we do on this channel. As always, if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and share it. Subscribe if you haven't. This was Andreas for Physiotutors. Thanks for watching and I'll see you next time. Bye.